Good morning, students. A very good and refreshing morning to all of you. So, here we are for your accounts lecture. And as you all know, we have covered basic accounting terms in the last week. I hope all of you have gone through the school videos, the reference links, and solved the worksheet too. So, today we are going to start with the next chapter, a practical chapter rather. So actually this chapter is the foundation, a base for your all practical based chapters, and its name is Accounting Equation. Okay, now equation. You all were in 10th standard and you must be solving equations. Forming equations and solving equations. Left side is given, finding the right side values are given, and find the missing value on the left hand side, right? So in accounts, we also prepare accounting equation. So now let us start with the topic. Before that, we all must do the learning objectives of why we are going to do this chapter. First of all, the accounting equation is considered to be the foundation of double entry accounting system. Like we are going to prepare P&L account, your trading accounts, balance sheet, trial balance. So different approaches are there, but this chapter is the basic chapter having few numericals which will be the foundation of your whole accounting. Accounting equation shows on a company's balance sheet where the total of all the company's assets equal the sum of the company's liabilities and shareholders' equity. Assets represents the valuable resources controlled by the company. The liabilities represent their obligations. Both liabilities and shareholders' equity represent how the assets of a company are financed. Financing through debt, that is credit, shows as a liability, and financing through issuing equity shares appears in shareholders' equity. So look at the figure here. Now you all are familiar with these basic accounting terms, assets, liabilities and equity. So on this balancing rod, assets are on one side and on the other side we have liabilities and equity. So assets are what the company owns, the company possesses. And liabilities are what the company has been obliged to pay to others. So equity is the proprietor's own investment. So when it balances, then an accounting equation is formed. The fundamental accounting equation, also called the balance sheet equation, represents the relationship between the assets, liabilities, and honors equity of a business or a person. It is the foundation for the double entry bookkeeping system. For every transaction, debits are equal to credits. So on left hand side we have debits and on right hand side we have credits. So all debits are always equal to all credits. Okay, let us take the example of a very familiar company whose product we all use, Nayasa. Nayasa or Nayasa. Its actually logo is Jeene Ka Andaaz Like New, Nayasa. It's a kitchenware and homemade products company that made affordable and one-of-kind home and kitchen storage products. It was founded by Vijay Sachdeva. Nayasa Group was founded in 1985. They export to fridge bottles with eye-catching designs. So, can we conclude out the meaning of accounting equation from this company? Sure we can, because they also do transactions. Recording those transactions through the way of your equity and liabilities is called accounting equation. Let us talk about few transactions involved in such a group. Okay, first of all, we will talk about the different partners which are associated with Nayasa company. So they are associated with, they are partners with Big Bazaar, Walmart, DMart, Max, Spencer, Trent, Reliance, Vishal Mega Mart, Spar, Metro. Something strikes at your mind or not? Might though it is there. Like I am giving the names of all chain stores and Nayasa is a partner with them. And we are talking about accounting equation. So what is the link here? So these partners, whenever you visit these stores, you must see a product range of plastic products. So Nayasa company has a partnership with all these departmental chain stores and their products are sold there. They must be sold at a discount. They must be displayed there. They must be sold at a reasonable rate. They must be sold at a profit margin there. So when we talk about profit, sale, purchase, discount, so what are all these terms related to? These are the terms related with accounts. And when we categorize the terms on the basis of assets and liabilities, then they form an accounting equation. The accounting equation is considered to be the foundation of the double entry accounting system. Accounting equation shows on a company's assets equals the sum of company's liabilities. Assets are equals to liabilities plus equity. As we have seen in balancing rod, assets on one side and liquidity, liabilities and equity on other side. Based on this double entry system, the accounting equation ensures that the balance sheet remains balanced, though, so that there should be proper balance between the two sides, and each entry made on the debit side should have a corresponding entry or coverage on the credit side also. The financial position of any business, large or small, is assessed based on two key components of the balance sheet, assets and liabilities. Owner's equity or shareholder's equity is the third section of the balance sheet. Accounting equation is a representation of how these important components are associated with each department. Accounting equation is also called the basic accounting equation or balance sheet equation. Now, there are four types of accounting equations. These are the balance sheet, the income statement, the statement of cash flow, the statement of owner's equity. In accounting equation, we show assets and liabilities. Similar is the case of balance sheet. In income statement, also we show all incomes and expenses. Same is the case of accounting equation. In the statement of cash flow, we actually consider the cash inflow and cash outflow. And the same thing we do in case of accounting equation. And also in the case of statement of owner's equity. So, we have four types of accounting equations. In today's video, we are going to discuss the following key terminology basically. First is accounting equation, then dual aspect, owner's equity and outsider's equity. Okay, let us now see what is accounting equation formula. Assets is equals to liabilities plus owner's equity. So while calculating the equation, first of all, we follow with the given steps. So first step is locate on the company's total assets on the balance sheet for the period. Total all liabilities, which should be a separate listing on balance sheet. Locate all shareholders' equity and add the number to total liabilities. Total assets will equal the sum of liabilities and total equity. So basic accounting equation is assets is equals to liability plus equity. For example, if liabilities plus equity is equal to 1,50,000, so on the other side, assets should also be equal to 1,50,000. Okay, now let us see what is accounting equation in a business. So we were saying accounting equation is assets is equals to liabilities plus capital. Assets is equals to liabilities plus capital, or we can consider it as equity. Now, when we expand equity, we have two types. One is capital, other is retained earnings. So all these terms we have discussed in our previous chapter. So what is capital? Amount invested by the businessman. And retained earnings are amount kept aside by the businessman for future use. Now, as it goes on increasing, assets is equals to liabilities plus capital. Now, what are retained earnings? Revenue plus expenses minus dividend. That is equals to profit. What is it equals to? Profit. So, what are retained earnings other names? Profits. So, now what are assets? Cash, accounts receivable, inventory, equipment. All these are assets. And when we talk about liabilities, we have accounts payable, short-term borrowings, long-term debt. When we talk about shareholders for equity, we have share capital, retained earnings, and so on. So, this is how accounting equation is made in a business. For example, if a company becomes bankrupt, its assets are sold. Bankrupt means now they have nothing to pay to the outsiders. So, its assets are sold. Funds are used to settle debts first. Only after debts are settled, shareholders are entitled to company's assets to recover their own investments. But equations must always balance. Okay, let us justify this statement with the help of an example. Purchasing a machine with cash. Now, I have purchased a machine and I have paid cash for the same. Okay, don't look into the answer and just tell me what is its effect. You have purchased a machine, you have paid cash. What happened in your business? First of all, a machine is there and afterwards your cash reduces. So, company XYZ wishes to purchase 50,000 machine using only cash. This transaction would result in a credit to equipment plus 50,000 and a debit to cash minus 50,000. Credit means increase and debit means decrease. 50,000 will increase as machinery, 50,000 will decrease as cash. So net effect would be, on asset side we will add 50,000 of machinery, but we will deduct 50,000 of cash, because the impact here is on assets only. There is no impact of this transaction on liability or equity. So now equation is balanced. On both sides we have zero. Why we have zero? Because 50,000 is added and 50,000 is deducted back. Okay, let us see one more example. Company XYZ wishes to purchase a 50,000 machine, as we were talking earlier, but now they have only 50,000 with them. 25,000 they will pay in cash, 25,000 they will pay later on. So when a machine is purchased, again equipment increases, machine increases by 50,000 and cash decreases by 25,000. Moreover, whom you have to pay becomes your creditor. One whom you have to pay becomes your creditor. It means it's your liability now. So 25,000 is your liability and 25,000 is reduction in cash. Remaining amount, this would result in a credit to equipment, 50,000. Equipment will increase by 50,000 and a credit of accounts payable. Accounts payable is liability or the creditors. So, they will also increase, and a debit to cash. Debit to cash is decreased because half payment was made in cash. Now, let us see how it will appear in an equation. Assets is equals to liabilities plus shareholders' equity, 50,000 of equipment, plus 25,000 of accounts payable and minus 25,000 paid in cash. So now liabilities, we have 25,000. No equity. This can also be done in the form of an equation. 50,000 we are running off machinery, 25,000 we are deducting because we have paid in cash, 25,000 which we have not paid, we are adding it to our liabilities. Now on one side we have 25,000, other side also we have 25,000. So accounting equation always balances. This transaction affects both sides of the accounting equation. See, this kind of transaction, it affects both sides, asset side and liability sides. Both the left and the right side of the equation increases by 25,000. So I hope now this starting topic of accounting equation is clear to all of you. Go through the PDF, read the PDF properly. Do refer the given link for more clarity. Watch the school videos and answer the following questions. Give fundamental accounting equation. Give two basic purposes of accounting equation. Accounting equation. What is accounting equation? Increase on assets and decrease